Hi everybody, how are you doing? I hope you're doing very well today. Today we're going to speak about the descriptive letter. As you all know, we have several criteria or several partitions in the letter. Number one, we're supposed to go on greetings. We're supposed to write the word dear, then the first name, then a comma, directly after the first name. Then when we go on writing the introduction, we should use or start our letters or our writings directly under the comma. And this should be applied for every paragraph, I mean introduction, three body paragraphs, and also the conclusion. How can I write an introduction? We have several ways. Number one, using an apology. Like when I say, I'm sorry I haven't written for a while, but I've been moving into a new house. Second one, it was lovely to get your letter yesterday, and here you're doing very well in your new school. A third way, we can say congratulations on passing the exams and getting the high scores or the high grades you were aiming to get. It was lovely to hear such good news, or I was over the moon to hear such good news. When we are done with the introduction, we're supposed to write directly a transition sentence at the beginning of the body, because transition sentences links the introduction and the body together. A transition sentence also can be used in three different ways. Number one, anyway or anyhow, then a comma after anyway or anyhow, and then we start by saying, I thought you might like to know something about my new life. Or you can forget about writing the word anyway or anyhow and say, I thought you might like to know something about my new life. I thought to put pen to paper and tell you something about my new life or my new school, and so on. A third way, we can use just a quickie or just a short note to let you know something about my new life, okay? And when you are done with the transition, we're supposed to check exactly what should we use or what should we write in the three body paragraphs. And again, make clear, any letter should be done in three body paragraphs. Do not exactly write two ideas together in one paragraph and think you are okay right now, or you are done what you need, or what the letter exactly, or what the examiner thinks this will be perfect. No, I mean, each one of those should be in a separate body paragraph. So again, three body paragraphs. When you are done with the three body paragraphs, we use what, guys? We use the conclusion. And much better to link our conclusion with what we started with. For example, as we started, I thought you might like to know something about my new life. When you end the conclusion, you can say, I hope this gives you an idea about how we live over here, and you are getting excited about visiting us soon, or about the visit soon. Okay? And then, in writing the conclusion, there should be one issue to be done, which is the ending. I'm looking forward to hearing from you soon. And take care, the word looking forward to should be followed by ing form. Okay? Then we have a signature. We're supposed to write yours with love or with love from. And then also a comma and the first name on the following line. Signature could be done on the left side or even in the middle side of the page. The best thing when you write, take care. Number one, create interest for the reader. Number two, personalize for your friend. Number three, support each idea you write. I mean, explain your idea very well. Do not list and do not state the obvious. Take care, your language is supposed to be a simple language. No high structure, no high vocabulary, using idioms, and of course, using figurative language. Doing so, you will do just fine. Thank you.